Now, not only is this year the 25th anniversary of Gardening Australia, it's also the anniversary of Landcare Australia.
When the earth is spoiled, humanity and all living things are diminished. We have taken too much from the earth and given back too little. It's time to say that enough is enough. We are declaring next year the year of land care.
So on Landcare Australia's silver anniversary, it's good to catch up with the man who launched it. What did you hope to achieve?
Well, it was a process and an end result. The process was bringing together formerly conflicting groups, the farmers and environmentalists, and through that combination, we'd harness the forces within Australia who had a vested interest in trying to ensure that our land was cared for.
And according to Dr. Shane Norrish, Director of Major Projects for Landcare, its role is just as important today as it was in the beginning.
It's incredibly diverse. The Landcare movement works on things such as habitat creation and protection, biodiversity improvement, water quality, things associated with agricultural production.
Is there any way of measuring your success?
One of the measures is that when Landcare was first started back in 1989, they were hoping to achieve about 2,000 groups around the country, but now there's more than 6,000 groups. The majority of Landcare groups draw on their volunteers, their motivation and enthusiasm, and then, where necessary, they bring in people with specific expertise.
Later in the show, I'll be back here in Clive Park to talk to one of the grassroots organisations that's doing all the great work here. Back here at Clive Park, I'm lending a hand to the local bush care group, just one of the many thousands of grassroots organisations supported by Landcare Australia.
I'm glad you could make it this morning.
It's good to be here.
Morning, Richard.
Meet Don Wilson, a passionate member of this bush care group and founder of their National Day of Action.
This little fellow, you'd know that one.
Asparagus fern.
Yeah.
Know it well.
Yeah, Costa, it used to cover the whole site here. Yeah, really? It's just about half an acre of it there. And when we first came, that was what we did. We took out the asparagus fern, and after a couple of years, all those little Aussie battlers, the little seeds that had been there for years, they all germinated, and up came these beautiful native plants.
Don, what inspired you to get involved with bush care?
It was actually a trip to Lord Howe Island, Costa. I came home one day from work and my wife, Marianne, said to me, do you feel like a trip to Lord Howe Island? She said, there's a weeding trip. I said, a weeding trip? Mm. I said, what, they pay your fare and your accommodation? She says, no, you pay that yourself. Ah, OK. Well, they just supply the tools, do they? She said, no, you take your own tools. I said, ah, this sounds irresistible. I've got to be in this. It was a real eye-opener on the environmental side. Someone at the beginning of the 20th century had brought in asparagus fern on a wedding bouquet that had either escaped into the bush or someone had planted it, and it had taken over 30% of the island. Climbing asparagus fern had climbed to the top of these big trees about 40 or 50 feet tall, and then the ground asparagus was all over the ground like a carpet. You couldn't put a spade between it. When we came back here, well, there was a pamphlet in the letterbox to join a bush care group at Clive Park. We came down and we found that there was only us and the convener there, and we started it ourselves.
Don and his wife, Mary Ann, worked tirelessly, clearing weeds and gathering support along the way.
I just talk to everyone. If there's someone walking past our bush care site, a lot of them say to you, you're doing a good job, and say, thanks very much, that's terrific. Would you like to join us? We've got some spare tools if you would.
You've really gone from strength to strength. Where are you at now?
Well, where we're at now, Costa, is a result of all the work we've put in over the years. We built our own group up here to 20 people, and then we started trying to help other groups. Then we dragged them all together with a first major day out. This year we've got 100 committed already. We're expecting something between 150 and 200 sites will take part. The purpose of Bushcare's Major Day Out is to spread the awareness to people, to first of all to make them realise that the bush is precious. What you don't do is dump your rubbish in it. You certainly don't grunt weeds.
What do you see people get out of it?
We know we're doing wonderful things. We're restoring the habitat. The birds are coming back. The animals are coming back.
My wife made those, and I can recommend them.
We regard it as our psychiatrist, as our gym, and as our social club. It's not hard. I'm 84, and I can still do it. And our morning teas are so good that there are people said, you're not a bush care group, you're a morning tea group. We know you pull a few weeds, that's all.
Oh, that would be big.
Yeah.